One of the tools that I use the most from artificial intelligence in preparation for some of the pieces that I need to produce or for my personal needs or for even for professional needs is Elevenlabs. Elevenlabs helps me generate voiceover from text to speech or from speech to speech even. And now they have a new functionality that allows you to create sound effects. So we'll go into that in a little bit, but let's start first with text to speech. So they have different models. What is a model? A model is like the skills that the artificial intelligence or the machine has. So what is the difference? The difference is more on the accuracy that you're gonna get from the tone and that you want to get from the voiceover. Why do I use this? And many of you that are voiceover professionals saying, "Ah, oh, this is destroying us and this is not good." So I think it's true. Many people are going to be using this instead of paying a human voiceover. But also the way that I use it is as a guide. So for instance, if I need somebody to record something for me, it is easier if I send that person a guide already recorded by AI, so that person can understand the tone that I want, or I could even send it to the editor so the editor can start working on that while I get the real voiceover. So let me put and use this example, and before that maybe we can go over pricing. So these are the plans. I'm on the starter plan right now. I'm already paying $5 per month because I have been with them for a while. I have 30,000 characters per month, which is 30 minutes of audio. Unless you're doing a documentary or something like that, you're never gonna use this. If you need more, the price is not that expensive, and if you go annually, it's even cheaper. But if you are producing extensive pieces of content or pieces of content that you require voiceover, and maybe you don't have the budget, because that's the other thing. Not everybody has the budget to pay the cost of a voiceover professionally when you are starting. So you could use services like Elevenlabs that I'm using. Let me go back here and I have already the text. Oh, this one wasn't this one. It was this one that I was going to copy. Is the text from the my newsletter edition 59. I put it here. You see I have a quota or a limit of 5,000 characters for every time that I'm asking the AI to do something. So in this case I'm going to start with 11 English version 2. Why? So I'm going to pick a voice. And you can hear, I even have my own voice clone.
All our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them.
Still, you notice it. I notice that it sounds like me, but it doesn't, it is not necessarily like me. I need to work more on that and probably add it again so the AI gets more familiar with my voice, but it still sounds very British and my accent is not completely, it's not American English, it is not British English, it is more like a Latino speaking English, and it has to sound more like that. But right now,
all our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them.
Sounds like it, but it doesn't sound like me completely. So let's say that for these texts I want somebody that it sounds American, and I want that person to sound well-rounded. For instance, Drew.
Love doesn't make the world go round. Love is what makes the ride worthwhile.
So that's one option. The other option, if I want a woman, is I want a woman with American accent. So let me see Emily, but Emily's meditation calm, so not what I'm looking for. Maybe Priya, I don't think it is that what we're looking for. Among the women, we have Nicole.
If one is lucky, a solitary fantasy can totally transform 1 million realities.
This is not what I'm looking for. Rachel is closer to what I'm looking for. So for this one, I'm going to pick Rachel.
Change in all things is sweet.
Leave it there. And it's recommending me to switch to 11 multilingual version 2. So I put it there and I hit generate. And you're going to start seeing in the bottom of your screen the results.
When I was in the second grade of elementary school, I received the worst advice of my life. It came from a teacher who was just trying to help, but achieved the opposite. You must be more humble and stop talking about yourself all.
And I'm gonna pause it. It keeps generating. But that there you have an idea of what you are getting out of this. So once it is generated and completed, it's going to tell me, oh, it is ready, and I can download that and add it to my timeline when I'm editing or sharing it with an editor or sharing with a producer that is working with me on this one. It takes not that much in generating this, but in this case, it's very, I like what I'm hearing.
I was 8 years old when I heard those words that made me feel terrible. He was in his 30s and was new to our school. Mr. Vargas barely knew his students, but he was quick at making...
So once I have this, I can just download it. And again, as I said, share it and start sharing it with whoever I need. As you can see, the process is very quick. It's very efficient. If you are not satisfied completely with what you got, you need to go back again and generate a new text, and that is going to consume out of the credits that you have. So for instance, you saw that for where I already, for this text that it's like a whole edition of my newsletter, I am consuming like 10% of my allocated quota for the month, which is not that much. It's going to take a couple of minutes probably to keep to finalize generating all of this. In the meantime, I'm going to tell you about the other tool that I use a lot, AI tool. It's Opus Clip. It is the tool that I use to generate the short versions or condensed versions of the videos that I'm creating for YouTube or any conversation that I'm interested in and that I have rights to use, that I want to get highlights to post shorts or to share with my team or to share with people around me. And it's really impressive. Let me, for this one, I'm going to use the link of my recent conversation with David Marlowe, the Ikigai guy, in my YouTube channel. So I just come and paste the link of my YouTube conversation, and I could just hit get clips in one click and it's going to generate, but I can tweak here what kind of subtitles I want, because as you have been seeing in platforms like TikTok or YouTube Shorts and even in Instagram, when you have these kind of subtitles, you get more traction because people don't have to wait to listen or to click to understand a little bit of what it is that you are watching or that they are going to be watching. You can even just add captioning without clipping it. You can, this video is 50 something minutes, so you can keep it and completely and add just the caption. This is 52 minutes. You can generate video in auto, or you can tell it what is it about. So it can, the artificial intelligence could understand a little bit more what it will be working. And you can select from it what is the length of the clips that you want. In my case, I want clips from 30 to 60 seconds because I use them for LinkedIn. I use them for YouTube Shorts. And I don't go by keywords because this conversation is very diverse. We talk about broadcasting. We talk about Ikigai. We talk about how to prioritize the important activities in your life so you can deliver what you need to deliver, and many other topics with David. So I'm ready, and I didn't choose this one. I think I'm going to choose Ali Abdaal styles of subtitles. I don't have a template. I could have templates, but I don't think I like this one, so I picked Ali Abdal's for this one, and I just hit click here. And as you see, I have, let me move this one for here. I have 57 hours, and it's going to consume like 30 minutes of this to do the clips. It is telling me that it takes an estimated of 16 minutes to work with, to create my clips. It doesn't take that long usually, but it could take a little bit. So let me hit pause here and come back when it is already completed all the recording. All the transcription and all the transcoding to generate my clips. Well, as you can see, now it is at 40%. This is a large video, it's over almost an hour, but while the video is ready and the short clips are ready, I'm going back to Elevenlabs. And as you can see, the generation of the voiceover for my whole text, the edition 59 of my newsletter, it's complete. It's 321, I can just download it and it will play.
When I was in the second grade of elementary school, I received the worst advice of my life. It came from a teacher who was just trying to help, but achieved the...
Again, it is not perfect. It doesn't get the tone for all the feelings that I want to transmit, but it does the job. And if I need to share something quickly, and or if I don't have, again, the money to do a professional voiceover to start, I can use this one, and it works very well. The last option that they added was sound effects. So I created the sound of a dog barking in the garden. Let's create a sound of a crowd celebrating a goal in soccer. So let me generate the sound effects. It takes out of my quota they give you, of my subscription. And it's pretty cool because sound effects sometimes are complicated or expensive or not good quality that if you record them by yourself, unless you are a really good pro in that. So let's hear what... I think options 1, 2, and 3 are pretty close to what I had in mind. 4 and 5 are not that much, but I have 3 options to pick from if I want to include in any video that I'm using or that I might be editing that need like the roar of the crowd when they are celebrating a goal. Let me go back. So this is Elevenlabs, as I said to you. And it's pretty good. It's pretty solid, and it's one of the best that I have tried of the ones that are out there. And then let's go back to OPUS. It's still working on this. It says 6 minutes still. So let's make a pause and we'll come back when the clips are ready. So exactly 17 minutes after, you can find here the shorts from my video, from a 52 minute video interview that I did with David Marlowe. So I got in total 29. So OPUS Clip classifies the shorts based on the power that these shorts could have with regards to the different algorithms or the engagement that they could have. So as you can see here, this one is a 99 out of 100. It says it has a hook of, which is an A minus, the flow, the engagement is an A, and the trend is an 8 minus. So maybe we can see it here.
Yeah. So Ikigai is a Japanese philosophy. It's a combination word. Iki and Kai, really, and then through a quirk in Japanese, it's combined, but it Ikigai, and it means life purpose. And if many people get hung up on Ikigai, they'll find it on the internet, and it's like this four circle Venn diagram that's about, you know, what you're passionate about, what you're good at, what you can be paid for, and or what the world needs and what you can be paid for.
So that is the explanation, the video, the result video, so I can download it here. I could even go and edit the clip. So for instance, in the beginning, it has these two that I might go in and edit them so they don't start at the head of the video. And as you can see, I have 29. So this took over 16 minutes. It could have taken a lot more to an editor to do it. And most important than that, yeah, we know that we need the jobs for the editors, but why not using the editor for something more important than cutting these clips for something more that is going to produce a bigger impact? So that's the functionality of OPUS Clip. You could even export this into Premiere Pro. You could even post it directly to the different social media platforms that you want to use them. Or you can download them in HD. Remember, if you are interested in content creation and the broadcasting industry and everything related to AI, you can subscribe to this channel. We will be sharing content continuously so you can keep getting more knowledge about it. Give us any suggestions that you have in the comments and we will respond to every single comment. I appreciate it.